In 1954, the United States was testing a new design for a hydrogen bomb. It was the same sort of weapon that would later be put on top of the Titan II. It had been anticipated that the blast would be about 5 megatons. That is the equivalent of 5 million tons of TNT. When the device detonated, there was an enormous explosion that got bigger and bigger and bigger. And soon, the observers were terrified because they didn't know when it was going to stop. The Bravo test wound up being 3 times more powerful than they had estimated.
I saw it go off from a distance of 200 miles. All you see is the light. The light stays on for a long time. And if you see it from total darkness, it gets bright enough to read a newspaper by that light. That's enormously impressive. Everybody knew that there was a great deal of radioactivity generated in a nuclear explosion. The question always was, what would happen to it?
Radiation survey teams were flown back to the exposed atoll.
We were able to document for the first time fallout data from high-yield detonations. Fallout blanketed areas of more than 5,000 square miles with radioactive material that would have been lethal to unprotected personnel.
Back in Washington, they took a map of the fallout pattern from the Bravo test and they superimposed it on a map of the United States. A similar weapon detonated over Washington, D.C., could release enough radioactive fallout to kill everyone in Washington, D.C., everyone in Baltimore, everyone in Philadelphia, half the population of New York City, with casualties and fatalities as far north as Boston.